and he merges them, and we get what's best for us. But this would be very unfair of us to be angry about, because although it is true that we don't always get what we expect, sometimes we get more than we expect. Nobody talk about that. God didn't do this. God didn't do that. I asked for it. I didn't get it. But what about when you asked for one thing and you got 10? Like the man in our story today. That man, when you research the text, he was carried daily to the temple for almost 40 years. And the Bible says that people would come in and give him some money. It's not that he was not in expectation, but he was not in great expectation. But he received more than he bargained for. He received the ability to do things he never did, like stand up, like leap, like walk, like praise and go to the temple. My question is, why didn't nobody ever take him into the temple in the first place? And we have to make sure that our lives are not like that. He had been there a long time. He got used to average. And so good became the enemy of his great. It was good enough just to get a few coins. But when they gave him something that money couldn't buy, then he was able to understand great expectations. Anybody know anybody that's been around the church all their life? It's not enough. You got to come in time. And you cannot only say, I'm in the church, but the church got to be in you. And I'm going to steal the words of Forrest Gump. That's all I got to say about that. I have one other verse for you. One other verse. In Hebrews chapter 4, verse 2. This verse right here may be the most important verse that I have read since I've been standing here today. And if we don't get the revelation of that verse, everything I said is in vain. So I really need everyone to please, I want you to look at it, actually, if you can. Actually look at it. Hebrews chapter 4 and verse 2. And it says, for unto us was, are you there? Okay, you gotta be there. This is, for unto us was the gospel preached, as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith. And then that heard it. Come on. I'm going to break that down and then we're going to pray. What Peter was saying is this. The gospel has not changed. He's saying the same gospel that was preached to him was the same gospel that was preached in other generations. But wherein he accepted Christ as Lord, he said the gospel that was preached unto the others did not profit them. As powerful as the word is, as powerful as the sermons were that were going forth, in spite of all the miracles that they saw, he said the word of God did not profit them, not being mixed with faith. So although they were able to say, oh, what a nice little sermon we heard today, or they were able to say, oh my God, what an awesome Bible study. It never got any further than that. Because there was no faith mixed with the word that they heard. And so the Bible says it did not profit them. Because it takes the faith to appropriate and apply the word that's spoken to us. When you get your hands laid on at the altar or someone encourages you, it cannot stop there. But you got to take that word and you got to see what God's word says about it and learn how to reach out and appropriate that word to your situation.